Hello everyone, Cherise here, and welcome to day one of my first ever holiday video series called Cherise Treats. There are 12 videos in this series, starting today, December 2nd until December 24th. I am so excited for all of you to see the videos I've been working on the past months. There are also giveaways to go along each video, so subscribe to the channel now if you haven't already so you won't miss any of them. Today, I'm setting up my 2022 bullet journal. If you're just starting with bullet journaling or if you're also migrating to a new notebook for the next year, I hope this video will help you out. So I'm currently in my Tiki Nara Dot Grid journal, which is from Notebook Therapy, and I'm now moving to a brand new notebook. This is the Tiki Cup of Galaxy Dot Grid journal, which is also from Notebook Therapy that was kindly gifted to me a few months ago. It has a 160 GSM paper with a deep blue linen hardcover and beautiful holographic foil cover design and page edges. If you're interested in my full review of their notebooks, I will link that video in the video description. And if you are interested to get anything from Notebook Therapy, my affiliate code Cherise10 will always give you 10% off. I think that's enough about the notebook, so without further ado, let's start with the setup. I started by writing my name using one of my go-to pens, Sakura Pigma Micron, on the very first page. As always, all the supplies I use in this setup are listed in the video description. Writing my name is always the exciting part, but also the nerve-wracking one because starting a fresh new notebook and writing on it for the first time makes my hands shaky. I know some of you can relate. But yeah, I just did a very simple cursive font and a couple of branches of leaves on both ends, and we are ready to create the actual spreads. On the left page, I'm writing out my bullet keys, which are the symbols I use for the status of my tasks and events. I also wanted this whole yearly setup to be simple, yet with a little bit of decoration, so I'm making the first letter of the titles of my spreads in a botanical or floral monogram style. I sketched the letters and the floral designs first with a pencil before outlining them with a pen. I also made the size twice bigger than the rest of the letters of the word. I started by outlining the flower and branches of leaves, then I shaded the letter to create a contrast or to make the letter and the botanical design stand out on their own. Then I added a few dots around to create a whimsical look. I initially thought of adding color to the flower and leaves, but I decided to just keep it black and white. Then I moved on to writing the rest of the letters for the word keys in the same serif font and a cursive font for the word bullet on top of it. This time, I'm using my Tombow Dual Tip Brush Pen in Pale Cherry Color to fill in the letters EYS and a thick line under it. Then I'm adding a shadow on the floral design using a light gray brush pen to make it pop a little bit. My bullet keys are very simple and easy to remember. Most of them are derived from the bullet journal method itself. I already mastered my keys for more than a year of bullet journaling, so I thought of skipping them in this setup, but I decided to still include it since I'm sharing this setup with you guys, especially for those of you who are beginners, so that you'll have an idea as well on what symbols you can include on your own bullet journal, but you can always come up with any symbol that will work for you. Moving on to the other side of the spread is my yearly cover page. It's always a nice idea to welcome the new beginning like a new chapter of a book, whether it's a year or a month, with a cover page. This time, instead of just writing 2022, like I would normally do in my past setups, I thought it would be cool to write them in Roman numerals. So I'm writing the letters MMXXII, that is equivalent to 2022. I'm doing the same process like you did on the letter K from the key page, but I also wanted each letter to be unique, so I'm drawing different kinds of flowers and leaves on different areas. You can see some are in front and some are behind the letters. So here I am patiently shading the letters with a small pen nib size, where I could have used a bigger one or a black brush pen. So if you wanted to do it faster, definitely use a bigger nib. And also you can play around with your colored markers and pens and make the letters as colorful as you want. As this cover page is slowly coming together, I really like how the floral details add a little bit of fun to the letters. And when I'm done with them, I added Hello 2022 in between the lines. And to finish this cover, I added shadows as well using a gray brush pen. So for the next spread, we are now doing my future log. This is a yearly overview to keep all the future events or occasions such as birthdays, holidays, and more, or just things that needs to be scheduled months ahead all in one place. So you can set it up by deciding the pages and the amount of months you will need. In my 2022 future log, I used two spreads with 6 months each, but this year I'm gonna be using one spread only because I honestly only have a few events to write and most of them are birthdays. So here I wrote the title Log the Future, which is not so typical for the future log title. Then I'm using the Tombow brush pen in gold ochre for coloring. I divided the spread into 6 months per page, then they are split into two rows, so 3 months on each row, and then I wrote the abbreviation of the months in small cursive handwriting, and then an individual mini calendar under each month. There are 6 spaces distance here, which is where I'm gonna write those future events, and I think that would be enough for me. In my very first bullet journal, I've used a year in a glance page. It is basically a full year calendar that you can write in one page, but I won't be including that this year again because the future log already serves as the yearly calendar for me, and it totally saves my time setting up a combination of both. But of course, you can always add a year in a glance page as well if you have time. On the bottom of the page to the right, I did the same thick line towards the opposite direction, as well as a whimsical botanical doodle. Moving on to the next page, this will be my goals for the next year. I'm keeping the same set of categories I have this year, which are personal, career, and creative. And I also added goals for my little family. I just divided the page into 4 sections. on the right side is my affirmations page, where I could write some affirmative, thoughtful first person statements to encourage positivity, calmness, and confidence. I thought it would be great to put it alongside my goals page that will help me believe even more that I can achieve these goals, or what we can also call manifestations. So yeah, I just kept it simple. I wrote the titles and another botanical doodle at the bottom, leaving the middle of the page spacious. I'm sure I'll be writing a lot of affirmations here. I decided to use green tones for the lines as well. I used Sakura Koi Raw Umber with green undertone and Tombow brush pen in avocado. And when I was doing this voiceover, I actually learned that green is associated with abundance, attraction, manifestation, and growth. So I'm glad I chose these colors for this spread. The next page is going to be my master to-do list. This is where I keep track of all the tasks I need to do that don't have any due dates or deadlines. Or whenever there is, I divided the page into two categories: for personal, such as health, chores, etc., and for work. I think this can help focus on tasks more deeply without worrying that I will miss something. Another collection I'm adding on my yearly pages is the Waiting On log. I usually use this to track incoming packages, and I include it on my monthly planning, but this time I will be using it not only for parcels, but as well as email responses, a letter, or anything I am waiting on. Then I divided the page into four simple column layout, where I will write the description, where or who it is coming from, the date, and the status, whether I received it or not. I won't be listing everything, but only those that I'm keen to receive, and that's it for my master to-do list and waiting on spread. Moving on to the next page, this will be my bucket list page. And by the way, I'm sorry my hand is getting on the way here. I wasn't able to check if the camera angle was good. But yeah, I'm going to migrate all the activities I wasn't able to cross out this year and probably list down some more new activities on my bucket list for 2022. This time, I'm not only writing an activity, but also when I am able to complete it and rating my experience from 1 to 10. If you have a bucket list, I would love to know what you were able to achieve, or the things still left undone, or maybe the craziest thing on your list. On the other side of the spread is for entertainment. This is a place for me to write down things I want to check out, such as movies, books, series, and songs that some of you recommend to me. So I split the page into four sections for each category. I'm also hoping this will help me catch up with reading books because I did create a reading journal setup. I have a video of that earlier this year, and I just honestly didn't get to use it as much as I wanted to for some reason, but I'm still hoping to make use of that reading journal this coming year. Now we're done with the bucket list and entertainment pages. Let's flip to the next one to create my finances page. So one reason why I changed up the titles for this setup is because I wanted most of them to have different letters in the beginning. I know it's weird, but anyway, this page is for me to track my income, expenses, and savings for the year. In 2021, I only tracked my savings, but I realized I should also keep track of my income and expenses so I can actually see my financial activity every month. So on the left side of this page, I listed all the sources of my income. For some reason, I wasn't able to list my expenses specifically, but I will surely add it later. And then the savings on the last row. I'm tracking the first 6 months in this setup, and I'm doing a Dutch door layout for this as I didn't think 6 columns will fit here, and I wanted each column to be this wide, so making a Dutch door would be perfect, so I won't have to write again the income, expenses, and savings. Then on the next page is the allocation, where I'm going to distribute those savings to categories such as emergency fund, for family, house, adventure, and technology. Then I wrote the first 6 months vertically and the total savings for each category. On the far right of this page, I included a small section for my wish list or just the things I want without immediate intent to getting them. And finally, we have come to the last spread that we'll be making in this setup, but definitely not the least. On the left page will be my socials tracker, just a place to track the subscriber and follower count of my social media handles. So if you are a part of this awesome and kind community, thank you for being part of my little family here on the internet. As a full-time content creator, I really appreciate all of you for your kind comments and for hanging out with me. So I made 3 graphs for YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok. You can visit my Instagram and TikTok pages on the description box below. I provided the links to those as well if you want to check them out. As you can see, I only wrote the initials of the months on the x-axis of the graph and left the y-axis blank. I thought of adding it by the start of the new year because in my setup for 2021, I surprisingly surpassed the target before the year actually started, so I had to cover the numbers up. I am truly blown away, but it surely was a wonderful mistake and I'm really grateful for that. And lastly on this page is for some video ideas that I would eventually create for you guys. So if you have any videos in mind that you would like to see from me, I would appreciate if you leave those in the comments as well. And then I also dedicated a small section for some inspiration or the content creators and YouTube channels that inspire me. I will list them down here in this area of the page. So I'm just finishing this with the final botanical doodle, and we are finally done with my 2022 bullet journal setup. And with that, it's also time to talk about our first Cherise Treats giveaway. I'm very excited to be partnering again with Notebook Therapy, and they are so kind to sponsor today's giveaway. For those of you who aren't familiar yet with Notebook Therapy, they are a stationery brand and their products are inspired by the East Asian culture. They offer the cutest stationery in my opinion, and the quality is perfect for my bullet journaling needs. They also offer free worldwide tracked shipping, which is super awesome. I have a 10% discount code for you, which is Cherise10, that you can use in their website. This way, you can also support me by earning a small commission whenever you use my code. So one of you will be lucky enough to win a Tiki notebook, a washi tape set, and a stencil set of your choice that is currently in stock from their website. There are so many beautiful designs you can choose from, so go ahead and check out the giveaway details on the video description to see how you can enter. I also provided the link to their website to see what you can win. This giveaway and in every Cherise Treats video are open internationally. I will pick the winner 48 hours after the video is posted, so make sure to follow all the rules in the description. So good luck everyone! And before I go, here's the final flip through of my 2022 bullet journal setup. I love the simplicity and functionality of this setup. I would appreciate if you leave your thoughts about it in the comments, and I hope you got some inspiration and ideas from this video. Thank you all so much for watching and joining me on the first day of this series. And with that, I hope you are having a wonderful day. I will see you on December 4th for Cherise Treats Day 2. Bye!